See here, example 4 of your book. Here it is given PQ is parallel to RS. An angle MXQ is given as 135. An angle MYR is given as 40. We have to find out the angle XMY. So what we will do? We will need to draw a line AB parallel to PQ through the point M. As shown in the figure, second figure, see the second figure. Now here already it is given PQ is parallel to RS and we are drawing AB is parallel to PQ. Just now we have seen in the previous session when the two lines are parallel to each other, third line is parallel and then all three lines are parallel. So here AB is parallel to PQ and PQ is parallel to what? RS. And therefore what is the relation between AB and RS? AB is also parallel to RS. Now angle QXM. See, I am reading and you have to look at the figure. Angle QXM plus angle XMB equals to 180. Now why this equals to 180? Because we have seen already in the pairs of linear equation, interior angles on the same sides. What is the addition of interior angles on the same side? Interior angles on the same sides are supplementary angle, means their addition is 180 degree. And therefore, angle QXM plus angle XMB equals to 180 degree. Now, already it is given here, angle QXM equals to 135. So, if you will substitute this value, we will get angle XMB equals to 45, means 180 minus 135. Now angle BMY, see I am reading here and there, it is a yellow shaded angles are given. Angle BMY equals to angle MYR. Why? They are the alternate angle. See the figure of Z they are making. Yes or no? Yes, they are making the figure of Z. And therefore that two angles are alternate angles, and we are aware when the lines are parallel, alternate angles are equal. And therefore we will write this angle as angle BMY is also equals to 40. So from this 1 and 2 equation we will get now angle XMY. How? See, angle XMY is divided by the line MB. And therefore, we can write this as angle XMB plus angle BMY. XMB is what? 45. BMY is what? 40. And therefore, their addition is 85. So, in this way, with the different figures and different numerals, we have to solve the problems by using the different pairs of parallel lines and the transversal midband, the different pairs of the angles.
See here in the example 5, if the transversal intersect two lines such that the bisectors of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel. See, try to understand the question here. The two lines are given, parallel lines, and then transversal is given and the corresponding angles are given, and that corresponding angles bisector are parallel given. Means see here a yellow shaded BENCG. So that two lines are parallel given, and we have to show the lines are parallel, that is PQ is parallel to RS. So that we have to show, and what is given here? BE is parallel to CG. So in the figure, if you will see, transversal AD intersect two lines PQ and RS at point B and C. Now ray B is what? B is the bisector of angle ABQ. The same way CG is the bisector of BCS. Now we know that we have to prove PQ is parallel to RS. Now let's start with the bisector which are given there. Now as B is the bisector of angle ABQ, angle AB is what? AB is equal to half of angle ABQ. Same way we will write here, angle BCG equals to half of angle BCS. But As these two lines BA and CG are parallel, these angles ABE and BCG are the corresponding angles. And lines are parallel means corresponding angles are equal. Now if you will see the equation 1 and 2 and 3, equation 1 and 2, its left hand side is equal. And therefore its RHS is also equal. And then we can equate it as half of angle ABQ equals to half of angle BCS. Half of gets cancel. What is the given here? Angle ABQ equals to angle BCS. Now see the figure. Angle ABQ and angle BCS are what? Are the corresponding angle, and corresponding angles are equal. Now corresponding angles are equal means what about the lines? Lines are parallel. This is the converse of corresponding angle axiom. So in this way, by showing the corresponding angles equal, we can show the lines PQ and RS are parallel to each other. See the next example. Here AB, see I am reading the question and you have to go through that point and lines. AB, locate the AB. AB is parallel to CD. Locate CD line, locate AB line. Then CD is parallel to EF. See here, locate the EF line. So AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF. What is the relation between AB and EF? They are also parallel, but that we will use in the solution. See the question first. Now EA, see the EA. EA is perpendicular to AB naturally because it makes the angle 90 degree with A at A. And angle BEF, see the angle BEF is given as 55 degree and we have to find out the values of X, Y and Z. Now let's see. If you will see CD is parallel to EF, it is already given. The angle Y and 55 forms the interior angles on the same side of the transversal BE. Transversal BE. Interior angles on the same side, that is Y and 55. So their addition is what? 180. From this we will get Y equals to 125. Now Y equals to 125. And AB is parallel to what? CD. AB is parallel to CD means X and Y becomes the corresponding angles. And corresponding angles are equal. Lines are parallel. Therefore, corresponding angles are equal. And therefore, Y equals to what? 125. X value is also equals to 125. So, in this way, we get the values of X and Y. Now we have to find out the value of Z. See here, AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF and therefore AB is parallel to EF. Now if you think about this line AB and EF, both lines are parallel lines. So therefore angle EAB and angle AEF or FEA you can say, the sum of that two angles equals to 180. Already we have seen the same we are using used previously in the same question. Interior angles on the same side of transversal. And therefore their addition is what? 180. Now EAB is what? EAB equals to 90 degree. And FEA equals to what? Z plus 55. So 90 plus Z plus 55 equals to what? 180. And this by calculation gives you the value of Z as 35. So in this way, dear students, using the different calculations, different pairs of angle, properties of the angles, properties of the lines and the different numerical values, you can calculate whatever the given here in the figure. So see here a small assignment for you based on the same topic. So it is exercise actually 6.2 from your NCERT notebook, NCERT book. But for this lesson I am giving you the fourth assignment. Already three assignments I had given to you. So first, second and third question. And this is the fourth, fifth and sixth question. Try to understand this question and try to solve these questions. And if you are unable to, I had given you the solutions of these questions. Go through these solutions carefully. Understand the question and note down and write down in your notebook of mathematics. See here, this is question third and question fourth. See, this type of question, if you are reminding it, we have solved in the standard 7th, I think. We have solved this type of question in standard 7th. Some questions we have already solved. So, this is question 5th and the question 6th one. So, dear students, understand this solution. Read it carefully, understand it and note down it in your notebook. And thank you. Have a nice day.